In this video, I will discuss how we can use the various grid factory routines in MRST to create unstructured grids. An unstructured grid consists of a set of simple shapes that are laid out in an irregular pattern so that any number of cells can meet at a single vertex. The topology of the grid will therefore change throughout space. An unstructured grid can generally consist of a combination of polyhedral cells with varying number of faces and cannot generally be referenced using a structured multi-index. The most common forms of unstructured grids are based on triangles in 2D and tetrahedrons in 3D. To illustrate this type of grid, we consider the Delaunay triangulation of a set of random points. We start by perturbing the vertices in a structured mesh, and then pass these points to this function triangle grid to build up an MRST grid structure. To construct the dual of this grid, we use the function PB, which connects the perpendicular bisectors of the edges in the Delaunay triangulation to generate a logically orthogonal 2D Voronoi grid. MRST does not yet have a function that generates Voronoi grids directly from point sets. Maybe you can contribute this. As an example of a more complex unstructured grid, we consider the C-mount point set that comes as part of MATLAB. The function triangle grid can take a triangulation as an optional parameter in addition to the point set. This triangulation can be constructed by any software you like. Here, however, we use MATLAB's built-in Delaunay function to generate a triangulation. This function is used by default in triangle grid if no triangulation is supplied. The industry standard for representing reservoir geology is to build volumetric grids by extruding 2D tessellations of geological horizons in the vertical direction or in a direction following major fault surfaces. The resulting grids are sometimes referred to as 2.5D grids. Here we use the function make layered grid to extrude the C-mount triangulation to a prismatic 3D grid. The same technique can be applied to any 2D tessellation. One advantage of using an unstructured grid description is that it enables us to easily construct grids having geometries and topologies that vary throughout the model. As a last example, I will construct a Cartesian grid that has a radial refinement to produce better resolution around the well. First, I use MATLAB's cylinder function to sample points on a set of circles of increasing radius. Then I generate points that will be cell centers away from the well and merge with the radial points from the near well region. I also add origin as an extra generating point to ensure that this point becomes the centroid of the innermost cell in the near well region. Finally, I eliminate any redundancy and pass the remaining points to the sequence of routines necessary to generate a 2.5D PB grid. Altogether, I hope that this video has provided you with some techniques you can use to generate grids that adapt to geological features, wells, etc.